I wanted to answer a question on this because I'm hearing this horrible thing many pastors are saying. I'm not saved yet. Nobody's saved yet. Nonsense. And they base it on this verse because they don't understand it. Let me give this to you. All right. Romans 13. And that knowing the time, that now is high time to awake out of sleep. For now is our salvation nearer than when we believe. See, we don't have it yet. No. I'm doing a video this week. I'm doing a study on all the verses that say saved or salvation. You could be saved from something other than your eternal soul. When Peter said, save me, did he mean save my soul from hell? No, save me, I'm drowning. So this means that our salvation is complete. See, our bodies are going to be redeemed. The salvation of the body, okay? The spirit has been sealed by the Holy Spirit until the day of redemption. See, when you buy something or you put something in a pawn shop, you have a ticket and you go in and redeem the item, okay? Christ made that payment on the cross. We are bought with a price. It tells us that, okay? So we're his. The spirit is done, okay? That's born of God. That's why one born of God cannot commit sin. The seed of Christ is in him, and he cannot sin. The seed of Christ can't sin. The Holy Spirit can't sin, okay? Then the body, the salvation of the body. See, we're saved from the penalty of sin now. But eventually, when we have the new body, we'll be saved from the presence of sin, the existence of sin, the fight with sin internally. Because our flesh wars against the spirit. The sin is in the flesh. That's why in my flesh dwells no good thing. The flesh profits nothing. Okay? So, it doesn't mean you're not saved yet. And that nobody really knows. No, yeah, we do. It says, I tell you these things to believe on the name of the Son of God. So you may know you have eternal life. Alright? Once in Christ. I love how Daniel's dad said it the other night. Once in Christ, always in Christ. Alright? You are part of his body or you are not. So let me give you a couple things on redemption here. First, let me read that promise to you I gave you in Ephesians. And grieve not the Holy Spirit of God. Why? Whereby ye are sealed until the day of redemption. How could we grieve the Holy Spirit by which we're sealed if we're not sealed by the Holy Spirit? And the Holy Spirit is the seed of Christ. And Jesus said, I'll never leave you or forsake you. You must be born again. How are you unborn? The Spirit doesn't come and go. It dwells within us. That's why it says we're bought with a price. It's the temple of God. All right? As many professing Christians don't have the Holy Spirit. They have not trusted in Christ. It says that we get the Holy Spirit because we've trusted in him. We've relied on what he did. We believe that his death, burial, and resurrection gives us eternal life. We know we have eternal life. That's salvation. It's relying on what he did. Period. Many believe he died, rose again, it was buried, and rose again. They don't believe he saved them, but he's Savior. They call his blood of the covenant by which we're saved an unclean thing because they just don't believe God. Okay, and here's where it's talking about the redemption of the body, the salvation of the body. Our salvation is nearer than when we believed. The body salvation. For this corruptible must put on incorruption, and this mortal must put on immortality. Okay, he's talking to saved brethren who are already saved. Salvation of the soul, finished. Salvation of the body, yet to come. Okay, you getting that? Let me say that again. Salvation of the soul, done. Salvation of the body, yet to come. So let's look at the verse again. Again, context, people. And knowing the time, that now is high time to wake out of sleep. For now is our salvation nearer than when we believed. And false teachers will say, see, nobody's saved yet. Because they don't rightly divide scripture. They wrest scriptures to their own destruction. So let me read a few things on redemption. It says, if there be, this is Leviticus, if there be yet many years behind, according to them, he shall give again the price of his redemption out of the money that he was bought for. So to redeem some of these, you pay for it and then you pick it up. You get it. Okay? So when Jesus redeemed us, he paid with his own blood to the Father for your sin debt. And it was received. Why? How do we know that? Well, because he rose again. It wasn't received on our behalf. It says his blood was sprinkled on the mercy seat. Okay? So redemption is to come retrieve the thing that was bought. And he promises that he will, if we are alive and remain at his return, then he will redeem us and give us our salvation of our body then. And then if we're are physically dead, then the dead will come back with him and the dead will be raised first. See, a lot of people think they come out of the ground. No, they're with the Lord to be absent from the body and to be present with the Lord. And then they're given their glorified body. It's flesh and bone. It's a literal body, just like Jesus, and he ate, and it's a literal kingdom and all of that. People don't realize it's just another dimension. It doesn't mean it's not physical. It's just a different physical. It's a spirit realm. So we're promised that glorified body. So that's what salvation is nearer than when we first believed. Okay? He's just redeeming us is the full pickup of the purchased item. All right? So I'm hoping I cleared that verse up for you. All right? It's talking about salvation of the body. Salvation of the soul is done. God bless.